Good morning, everyone. My name is Christian from Two Headed Wolf Gaming, and welcome to a brand new day here in Graveyard Keeper. We go now on a journey to get ourselves some more ink. And I was thinking whether we should be starting making our own as well, but I have no idea how to make the ink. No, we should probably start by building one of these, the church workbench. We had a few things for the, how is it called? Doesn't come to mind right now. Well, whatever that workbench underneath the church is that breaks down materials, like they might break some color. I keep thinking about pestle, though I'm sure that's not how it was called. Let's collect some apples while we're here in the area. Now talk to our friendly little astrologer, and we could ask him to provide us with two of these. It's gonna take most of our money. There we have it. And before moving on, there was something we said that we would do yesterday, and that is to explore, to go and check up on the town. Tomorrow is also Sunday, so we need to go get our prayer book and make sure we keep the sermon. We need 7 faith in order to upgrade our next prayer book, right? We were going for that combo prayer, for which we are making an even better prayer book. Let's see. Okay. Apparently we are Sard. What the heck was that? I think I was struck by lightning on my way to the town. I felt it. An ancient and powerful rage bounced on over here immediately. It would seem that someone or something of great power doesn't want you in the town. I'm not sure. Actually, I'm pretty sure that if you keep trying, things will end badly for you. Like, I'm talking skull now. I'm a talking skull now, bad. But I need to go there. There's some magic items I need to track down. I need to go home. I'm a little offended that you're trying to leave me. But as your friend, I suggest you talk to the sweet snake in the church cellar. I think he'll be able to find these items for you. He's quite a nimble rogue. You know Snake? I talk with him all the time. I hide in a pile of dead skulls and we talk. He thinks I'm his inner voice, so he's very open with me. Did he tell you anything interesting? As his inner voice, I find that question most unethical. Okay, I'll talk to Snake. Maybe he'll be able to help. Did we spend that money and can't really go to town? Now that would be rude. Let's start to make some books. We have plenty of paper, we have plenty of everything. I want us to go ahead, let's see. I'm going to go here. We will need a book. That is the important part here. A combo prayer is a mix between prayer for the nation and prayer for faith. I see. If we have industriousness, playwright, and writer, we could get some more quality out of it. We could go for a prayer for the repose. I see. Or prayer for prosperity, or prayer for repentance. Let's take a look at these books once more. in theology they should be. This is sermon money, sermon faith, earn extra faith and donations. I think I like that though, more than anything else. Yeah, you know what? Let's go with that. Let's go with the combo here. So for that, I will need to write a book. For the book, we will need a chapter. For the chapter, we will need notes. And for the notes, we will need to write some. Let's see. We have 5 stories. We can make one. Oh, we can make a few of them. Silver. We make 2 silver stories. We'll make 1 chapter silver. That means that there's a bigger chance that the chapter will turn silver, and if that is true, then there is a chance that this will be silver, which I don't think changes much. Do we want to do the cookbook first? No, I think I prefer the face. So let's start writing this book. Apparently it didn't turn out right. I guess there's not a huge chance for them to turn to silver, so let's just make bronze then. Let's see, 1 chapter here. We will be needing only 1. Okay. Well, let's craft this one. And then we'll go here. Yes. Let's write the book. There we have it. We've got some good blue points. And we have enough ink, clean paper, and red wine to make the cookbook. So let's work on that as well. There we have it. We made ourselves a cookbook. It's almost daytime to where we would be able to pray, receive some faith. Not gonna be. I think we'll need 2 weeks in order for us to be able to create that prayer book. But everything counts. Every small progress is a progress. Every day we are moving further ahead. Not sure what we're going to do about the town, but we'll have to ask Snake and go from there. Maybe even talk to the merchant at this point. He seems to know a little about the town. We get some more reputation, maybe we'll be able to repair their water supply. Now I'm very happy we didn't throw anything into the water. I even want to go into the dungeon again. So let's go out through the church. We'll gain 1 more fate point here. And the story. That's good. I mean, everything is a plus now. Do you think that we can light some candles? Let's see. If I bring from here, no, it's outside of the church. Let's go outside the church. Let's take some candles. Let's also take these donations from last week. Just 2, please. Here we have 1, 2 that could use a funerary stone. Hey, there we have it, and we gained one more point. I think this is only temporary, so our church is great, nice. We've gained 5 points. Come on, we need one more. We definitely will get one more, right? Yeah. Great sermon, everybody's happy. We have quite a big flock. If they, everybody's giving like this amount of coins, next week we'll be rich. So here we are at the crafting bench. We're going to go with a prayer combo. Yeah, we won't be getting any of this. Any work develops you, even the work of evil. You've accepted your dark side and it's enabled you to craft more effectively. Okay, sure. And now we have ourselves a combo prayer. This is going to give us times one faith, but sermon faith plus 50%, sermon money plus 50%, and one silver. We can sell, I think we can sell the old prayer book. Let's collect some of this money. Another two silver there. Prove our reputation with him by selling this book. Let's take one log with us. And what do you think we should be doing next? Let's also give Donkey send cookbook. And we've done that. Here apparently we're done with the wheat, so we're going to collect it and replant it. One, two, three, four, five, six, and seven here. Now we'll fertilize everything else with what we have. Oh, it does seem like we're running out of peat. We'll probably need two of these. And we are losing seeds every time we replant them. Seems like we can't really keep up. Let's make some dough. Throw this in. See, yeah, I would like to build another one of these compost heaps and work on it. And then add some material to make it. I'm not sure for fertilizers what we will need, but it might be one of the main ingredients there. So let's see now, for flour, we can make a whole lot of flour out of this. Like, look at that. What do we get? Green points? Yeah, 2 green points per. There's a lot of work to be done here. Donkey came and he picked up the book, the cookbook for Ratatouille. So now we have plenty of flour and we're going to make some more. The next step will be to make some dough. But for now we're going to go to sleep and I'm going to talk to the lady at the inn for some more information. She wants the necklace. We already spoke to her, right? So then there's no need to talk to her. Let's throw in or take the apples and we'll put them downstairs. I am going to throw here. What's next on it? Like, let's throw these scraps, the complex iron parts. We can throw in some of the things that they are already in. These boxes. Don't see the zombies bringing a whole lot of resources for some reason. We should check on the situation up there. For now, whetstone, put it there. Yeah, and we'll take the rest underneath the church before we go on another journey into the dungeon. Try to find those nails that we can give Snake, so he can give us a stamp, so we can sell some meat. And I don't know what's next, but I think that that's how it should be going. Throw in the story, throw in... Take wine, take health potion. We were going for the witch as well. Zombie juice will give away chaos solution, the paper. And we'll just go and put the apples here. Let's see. Take the note from the contraband box. So the donkey brought something to us. And we can talk to him about it. Or read the note that he just left. Meanwhile, let's explore the dungeon. Let's see where we were left off. I think it was at level 3. Let's see, level 3. We have full life, full energy. I think we'll be fine. Is there... I think there was a different level of weapons and armors, right? Let's see. Yeah, steel sword, steel armor, and then steel sword with gem. Damask sword with gem. Ah, quite a few good ones. Swordmaster, you know how to use a blade, you inflict a digital daemon and probably look cool with your sword. Gold jewelry, jewelry table. Probably by making jewelry, we have a higher chance of increasing our reputation with the blacksmith. Probably the way to go. It does seem a bit weird to me that we didn't find any nails so far. Okay, how do these bees work? Okay, they just come straight at you, and that is toxic powder. Toxic powder, acceleration powder, and slowing powder. So that's how we'll make potions. Lentil seeds. And that's how we become the best farmer in the area. Okay, that takes a lot of health, 8 health per hit. Those bees or those flies are pretty bad. How do we go like... So, and then do this. Let's heal up. Okay, let's attack here. Nice. I am not sure what that wing does, but it seems to have bugged out. Nice! I'm really happy we have upgraded our weapon. Seems like we can do really well in these dungeons. We have plenty of energy left, we have plenty of life left, we have some wine on us so we can drink up and heal up. Okay. Let's drink one more bottle of wine. So I'm amazed at the fact that we're not getting drunk. Okay, we've collected... Oh, we collected that wing too. Yeah, and still we haven't found any of the nails. Snake is coming to us tomorrow, so I'm hoping that we can get what we're looking for. What are those? Okay, so now we found some bloody nails. Now it's starting to... And these dungeons start to look interesting and dangerous at the same time. Okay, more wood. More wood for the fire. Nice. We need just one more of those enemies. And then we'll be fine. That's all. One enemy. Okay, flitch, metal scraps and simple iron parts. Let's see. Is there any way we can prevent damage? Doesn't seem like it. I think at this point we do have, yeah, we have 6 bloody nails, that's enough. We're not going to explore the rest, we're gonna leave it for a different time. We have little life left, there's no use in spending our potions for nothing. If the quest doesn't require us to go deeper, then we're not gonna do that, we're just gonna go home. Snake should be in the dungeon pretty soon. We can provide him with what he asked for. Let's see, anything else at the moment? Doesn't seem like it. We have some resources, some lentils, we have slowing powders and a few other that we could bring where. So we have these, we have the hand mixer, we have an alchemy workbench, an alchemy meal is what I wanted to say earlier, distillation cube, make an alchemy rack and a scroll shelf for paper. We need just some nails for this one, for that we need a bit more, but just going ahead, make a bunch of nails and see if we can store away some of our paper, seems like the right plan to do. Let's throw in the wine here. Okay, well, let's make the nails, I said. So, nails. 44 nails. Which is plenty. Okay, now we can go make a scroll shelf. And wait for Snake. I think this is Snake's day, right? Let's make sure we're not waiting. No, tomorrow is Snake day. Today is the merchant. Okay, well, there's no need to wait for Snake anymore then. And we can build. We're gonna take one of these days, we're going to have to organize this area as well. Let's see. We can place it here or here or somewhere here. Let's place it there. We have a bit more energy and now we could be able to scroll shelf. Let's see, Oh, we can throw everything in. It's just a storage. Huh. Well, I guess you can put anything on a storage. Right. Health potion. I want to give the health potion to the witch. Let's take some of these away. Anything that can make paper or ease paper, I want to put that in the scroll shelf. Leave the rest of them here. Maybe even the ones that make potions, we'll put them here in the scroll shelf. Let's see, stories, zombie potion, recipes, anything else? Paper. Batwing. Batwing, we'll put the batwings here because we might be transforming them into other materials. And with the metal scraps and the jelly, we'll leave them inside the house. Let's go out through the church, see what the donkey left us. What letter did he leave us? What are we doing for the future? And what about an embalming station? What does that require us? I need to look at it again. Planks, complex iron parts, and nails. Okay, revolutionary message. Glory to the donkey people. 1. The rat's chief can't read, but he enjoyed the pictures in your cookbook, so he ripped them out and ate them. 2. There weren't enough apples, so donkeys fought each other over them, and there were a lot of casualties. But they appreciated the effort. You have passed the first stage of earning the approval of the Ecopod. And then you'll receive stolen bank checks and pieces of jewelry via the box. Write and send aphorism about the harmfulness of money, and we'll put them in the letters instead of the checks and jewelry. Also, sell the jewelry and send the money to us. This will aid us in our great endeavor. They just said money is harmful. Although you're right, money is harmful. So you can keep the money for yourself and send us 5 faith that we may maintain our trust in a bright future for donkeys. Let's keep our tails crossed. If their Edo Pop won't pay me for my help, I'll put poison carrots into their donkey box. Create aphorism about the evils of money. They're readable, not masterpieces, but written with feeling. We gained a new achievement called Cook of Revolution. Okay. So now we have something new that we can create, huh? How interesting. Let's make some more peat. Let's collect these and craft it again. We should go fishing. I was thinking about these worms, these maggots, that we could go fishing with them. Throw in the seeds. Let's make some planks and some complex iron parts. Here, complex iron parts. We don't have enough energy left. So I guess at this point, we're just going to rest and put a cut into this episode. Next time when we'll come, we'll take on Snake, give him the nails, get the stamp, continue the journey from there. There's a lot to do, but for the moment I need to take a break for myself and rest my voice. As for the moment, thank you very much for watching. I hope you have enjoyed a wonderful journey in Graveyard Keeper, and I look forward to seeing you all in the next episode. So have a wonderful day, everyone, and a wonderful week ahead.